So basically what we have to realize is that Netflix is the ultimate recommendation application in a sense, because if you think about it, the entire interface is about recommendation.
This is Anne-Marie Kermarrec, the Director of Research at INRIA, Rennes. She is also a scientific collaborator of the IC School at EPFL, as well as founder and CEO of Mediego, a startup that provides systems for real-time online content personalization.
I don't know if you're familiar, but they tell you which TV show you're going to like, you know, which movie you're going to like based on what you like. And they put a lot of effort in their recommendation algorithm. And they say it's worth, you know, $1 billion because it's very important to them.
Think about it. The recommendation system of Netflix is valued at something like $1 billion. And that's not so surprising. Their whole business relies on people wanting to log in order to find something that they'll enjoy. And Netflix's business is a huge one. In 2016, their revenues were estimated at $8.8 billion.
Now, a while ago, they organized this prize, which was called the Netflix Prize, where they would offer $1 million to any research group, which would improve the precision of the algorithm by 10%.
This was on October 2nd, 2006. It was the beginning of an incredible race. By October 15, three teams had already beaten the Netflix algorithm by over 1%. 8 months later, in June 2007, over 20,000 teams from 150 countries were registered.
That created a lot of efforts in academia. And then eventually this has been solved by the top researcher in the field.
In fact, it was 2 years later, in June 2009, that the merger of the teams Belko in Big Chaos and The Pragmatic Theory, called Belko's Pragmatic Chaos, finally achieved a 10.05% improvement over Netflix's algorithm. But it wasn't over. Other teams then had a month to improve upon this result. The Netflix prize competition was to end on July 26, but on July 25, the team The Ensemble, which was itself a merger of Grand Prize Team and Opera Solutions and Vandelay United, achieved a stunning 10.09% improvement. To settle the competition, a grand final test was organized on September 18. Both teams achieved the same result. But the winner would be Belko's Pragmatic Chaos because they submitted their results a mere 20 minutes earlier. This is quite a thrilling story. I bet it wouldn't be the worst Hollywood movie. In fact, I wonder if Netflix could make a Netflix movie about the Netflix competition. Inception.
Now, there were one interesting issue, you know, outcome of this is that it has never been used as such, okay, even though it would improve the precision by 10% now, and that was one of the goals. And the reason why, it was very, very complex to implement. And so, in theory, it was providing a much better result, but then in practice, that was very hard to implement. And this is really the case when it comes to putting something in production. So not only the precision matter, but how you can scale the algorithm and how it can work in practice is also very important, because otherwise you just cannot use it. I mean, users today are completely impatient. In a Netflix application, I think the average degree patience of a user is about 60 seconds. If you do not provide within 60 seconds what a user is going to watch, then the user goes somewhere else. And that's very patient, because most of the web application, it's 4 seconds. So, you know, it's a very good one.
Now, given the success of the Netflix prize, it's almost surprising that Netflix didn't organize a second edition.
The other part of this story is that they organized a second Netflix prize, which was number two. And then that one had to stop for privacy issues, because basically, well, so obviously to have researcher work on a recommendation algorithm, data matters. Okay. So Netflix provided a database, anonymized to the researchers so they can work on this. Now, some researcher, from, I think, Texas, basically discovered that if you correlate the data, anonymous data from this Netflix database and the one from IMDb, you could actually come up with some privacy leaks for users. So then the second edition of the Netflix prize stopped for this reason, for privacy reasons.
The group's grand prize winning model gets its answer by taking the average of 800 different algorithms, enough to fill a 150-page book.
And I don't think when we started, anybody expected that that would be the way to win the competition.
Today, there are many applications and systems which actually rely on the recommendation system.